What's going on, everybody? My name is Jonathan Kowalsky. I'm a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. We're over here at the Jog Center in Los Angeles, where we like to roll around and play. Today, I'm just gonna demonstrate a couple of basic moves in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu with my friend, Naomi.
Hi.
So, Naomi, you have how much experience in Jiu-Jitsu? Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, zero experience. So we're just gonna do a couple basics. This is not necessarily for self-defense, this is a sport. That said, you can apply this sport to self-defense. Self-defense is really about extracting yourself from a bad situation, which is not talked about in most self-defense videos. First move we're gonna learn is a rear naked choke. And we're gonna start with back control. Ideally, you'd like to get your legs in. They're also called hooks. One hook in, the other hook in. And then we're gonna do what's called the seatbelt grip. We're gonna have one over her neck, one under her armpit. So right now, this is your choking arm, this is your non-choking arm, obviously, because this arm is under her armpit. This arm could go around her neck. So we're gonna protect the choking hand by covering this. So if she does break my grip, if you do break my grip, yep, you're gonna grab my hands and push it down. So go ahead and do that. If she does break it, then this choking arm comes right up. So again, we're just going the basics of a rear naked choke. Ideally, we're gonna cover the choking hand. We're gonna shoot it up like a snake all the way across her back here to where the crook of your hand is gonna be on her esophagus. So each point of your elbow is gonna be on her carotid arteries. We're gonna use our head to jam it in there. You're using every appendage of your body to asphyxiate is the word. We could extract this hand. Now like a snake, we're gonna use this hand, snake it behind the head. This hand's gonna grab your own bicep, and you're gonna have one grip here, one grip here, your head's gonna be close to this head, and the pressure isn't coming back or squeezing, it's coming down, and you're just gonna tap. So now you're gonna do it to me, you're gonna do a seatbelt grip, exactly. This is your choking hand, you're gonna cover the choking hand. This is gonna shoot up to where the crook of your hand is gonna be on my esophagus, so you can let go of this hand, it's gonna shoot up, grab the back. Use your head to push your head into the crook. Now I want this to snake, like a snake, behind my neck, behind my head, excuse me, and this is gonna grab your own bicep. This hand is gonna grab your own bicep. Good. That's gonna apply pressure there. So here you have both the crooks of your arm on my carotid arteries. I want you to squeeze together and down using your head. See how my voice is going down?
That
using
is?
Your head, yep, and now squeeze together and down.
Down?
Yep, and hard. Keep coming. Tap. Already I'm a little lightheaded. And that is a rear naked choke.
Fight commentary breakdowns. I'm here with Jonathan from Grappz.
What's up?
And Jonathan, what are Grappz?
Grappz are a finger support compression glove. It's the better alternative to taping your fingers.
Wow, and you designed them, right?
I did. I created these from scratch.
Wow.
I've been wrestling since I was a kid, judo, Brazilian jiu-jitsu, mixed martial arts. My fingers have been banged up. Had surgery on my pinky, multiple dislocations on my left ring finger. On my right hand, I broke two of my fingers. And unfortunately, I hate taping just because the sweat, the grappling, when the tape ended up on the mat multiple times, I didn't get the full ability of making a fist or contraction of my fingers. So I actually, the story's cool because I tore my ACL, which put me out, and that is where the birth of Grappz happened.
As you're resting, you got the inspiration.
Healing, yeah.
That's
right. I got the inspiration.
Wow. So for those of you who want to check out the product,
go to getgrappz.com. That's GETGRAPPZ.com.
So some basics we want to emphasize about rear naked choke is the carotid arteries. The choke is not to crank the neck or to squeeze the esophagus. This is annoying, but it will not put someone to sleep. Your carotid arteries are on the side of your neck. The real objective is to stop the blood flow to the brain, and that is what a lot of people forget. What they're gonna do sometimes as a mistake, you'll see someone put the forearm across the neck and they'll just push and just try to squeeze, and at a high level, you're just gonna make the guy upset. You're gonna put your forearm across, it's gonna suck, but you're not gonna make me fall asleep. Ideally, what you wanna do is take the crook right under your esophagus. So both corners of your arms are on the carotid arteries, and the pressure is coming from behind you and down. It's not pulling back and squeezing. It's here, here, like this. The other thing that people mess up is when they go back with the choke. So if I'm choking this way, there's two directions you could fall back. This side, sorry, Naomi, or this side. You always want to go to the choking arm side. So if I'm choking, I want to fall to this side. A couple of things you want to think about when you are getting choked by a rear naked choke. So ideally, it's a chess game. You want to anticipate it coming. So I would always keep my chin down and tucked and try to catch the hands. But if you do get the choke in and you're fully in, you're getting the rear naked choke, you have it fully in, this goes on the bicep, this snakes in behind the head, behind the neck. You got that under there, there you go. Now you're in. So like I said prior, this, she wants to take me to that side. I want to go to that side. So ideally I want to get my head and I'm going to use my explosive muscles to get my head on this side and bring it down. Hold on to the choke hard. Don't let go of the choke. Hold on to the choke. I want to come to this side. I have my whole lower body. I want to get my shoulder blades to the mat. So I'm going to use my lower body to turn my hips, get my shoulder blade to the mat. The choke is off. Yeah, and even at a high level with really strong guys, I feel really comfortable with guys on my back. I could escape just by doing those basics, by using my whole body. A lot of times when they have the hooks in, you'll see guys' legs dead and they're just trying to get their shoulders to the back. What I say is use your lower body to scissor your hips, get your hips back, get your shoulder blades to the mat on the non-choking arm side.
So we're on Twitter and Instagram at Grappz Official. That's G-R-A-P-P-Z Official. That's Twitter and Instagram. We're just Grappz on Facebook and our YouTube channel. Just search Grappz and you can subscribe to our channel. A really awesome thing is part owner of this company and extremely helpful in the development of these gloves is Olympic gold medalist Kurt Angle. Kurt is a good buddy and business partner of mine and has been very insightful and very open with interviewing him about his history. So it's really cool. We have a lot of great content of Kurt on our YouTube channel. Some just good information from back in the 90s when he won the Olympic gold medal and to today to WWE stuff. Check us out.
Definitely. And big shout out to Jog Center also.
Jog Center. It's my home right here. That's where I train.
Where you train.
If you're in LA and you want to train some really high level BJJ or MMA or Muay Thai, come to the Jog Center in Hollywood. Some great, great guys. There's no egos here. Some great instruction, some great rolling, great striking. Very fun place.
Awesome. Thank you, George.